So this is Cyberburn Scroll coming at you with a late review. Of course, I'll try to be up to date next week of River of what am I saying? DC Legends of Tomorrow's newest episode, River of Time. So in this episode, basically where last episode left off, we start where Savage is has been imprisoned on the Wave Rider because Kindred didn't have the balls to kill him, and so. This episode was pretty great, I would have to say. It was really enjoyable. Of course, there are some moments that weren't so good, which we'll talk about, but overall, I think this is pretty fantastic, considering this has become a show that I like a lot better than I actually like Arrow. Even though it sprung off Arrow and Flash, it's had some problems, but it's been pretty great this season. But anyway, let's get back to the episode. Basically, Savage is using his manipulation to try to get all the members of the team turned against each other, and the engine breaks down because Rip wants to makes a bonehead decision to try to get to the vanishing point too quick. And Rip, I understand what they were trying to do this episode, but still, I think Rip's smarter than that, and I don't think he'd make an irrational decision. But of course, it was for the story, so it's not like a reason to give this show a bad score, but I thought it was a little bit stupid how he had to get to the vanishing point right away. And I understand that his family is dying, but still, I don't think it was like a strong enough motivation because he seems like a cool and collective captain, but he is flawed, so I guess that's why they portrayed him, wanting to push there as quick as possible. But anyway, so Vandal Savage actually this week was more terrifying than he has been all season. He turned every member of the team against each other, pitted them once against each other, and eventually how he escaped is he got Ray to want to fight him and go open the door and start fighting him, and of course Savage knocked him out and got escaped from the pod, and so did what is his name? Hawkman. I can't believe I can't think of his name. His Carter. Carter. So, brainwashed Carter. So I would say that was a high point of this episode. Vandal Savage just actually being a pretty decent villain and using his manipulation to turn everybody against each other. Also, I would say the flashbacks did a great deal this episode. The flashback where Ray was talking to Felicity, it was actually great. Actually added some substance to Ray. This season he's been in that Kendra subplot with Kendra love triangle with him, Carter, and Kendra, and it's been like sort of dragged his character down. But I feel like the Felicity thing was actually nice, surprisingly, because I don't really like Felicity on Arrow. To I don't know, sort of round off the character. I would say Jax was trying to fix the time drive. And so it accelerated his aging process. So Stein had to send him back to the past, 2016, to reverse the effects. And I thought that was pretty great because Stein knew that Mick and Snart wanted to use the pod to get back to the other time to escape the ship because, of course, Vandal Savage was loose and they were. Just stuck there. And so I thought that was pretty great that it was a great moment for Stein, knowing that even though he had the threat of what Mick and Snart would do to him, he's still sent him back anyway, because he actually cared about him. I would say the fighting was sweet at the end, with Savage breaking out and trying to kill everybody. There's some funny moments where there's one moment where Savage is like, "You can't destroy me, I'm a god," and then I am a Vandal Savage, ruler or destroyer of nations, and then Snart said, "I am Leonard Snart, a robber of ATMs," and I was just laughing for a few minutes about that, and so that was great. The humor was interspersed throughout, but all the flashbacks were good for every character. Jax, of course, with his mom, Sarah with Nyssa, and Ray with Felicity. They're all great, and they sort of rounded out the characters. I would say the reveal at the end that the people at the and the, that are part of the Time Council were working with Savage the whole time was pretty great. It wasn't not expected, but like I was sort of expecting it, but because there's two episodes left after this one. But that was pretty cool. That once they got to the vanishing point, they tried to turn in Savage, and then it turns out he's actually working with the Time Masters. So, yeah, this episode was fantastic. The action was great. The flashbacks were great. The only thing that was annoying, of course, is the Kendra Ray Carter love triangle. But even that, whenever Carter broke out of the brainwashing and beat up Vandal, that was pretty cool. That was pretty awesome, I had to say, when his wings went full spread. Of course, he got stabbed again. I thought he was gonna die for a second. I was like, "You're really gonna kill Carter again?" But no. But when he eventually came out of the brainwashing and, of course, fought back at Savage, and then Kendra beat up Savage, and they're all saved. But it took all the team working together to take him down after he'd escaped. So great teamwork, by all the cast and such. And so they get to the vanishing point at the end, and of course, like I said, you figure out that they were actually working with Savage the whole time to give him the future tech, and I thought that was really cool plot twist. And I think it was Sarah and Snart had time to hide before they were captured, and so Sarah and Snart will be breaking everybody out next episode, so that'll be interesting to see. But overall, this episode was fantastic. The only thing wrong is the love triangle, but that's been going on all season. And the one-liners by Snart and Mick were great. So I'd give this episode a 9 out of 10. I just really like the show. I may be a little bit biased just because how much I enjoy every character except Kendra. So, and Carter's okay, but he's not the worst. But anyway, I'd give it a 9 out of 10 for intense action. Great character development, great flashbacks, and Vandal Savage stepping up as a villain this week. So, this has been my a little bit longer review than 5 minutes of Legends Tomorrow, River of Time. I give it 9 out of 10. This is Sideburn Scroll signing off.